Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will study various addressing modes in the 8085. In the last video we have already started the programming model of 8085. Now before moving towards the instruction set, first we need to understand this instruction falls into some categories of addressing group. So what are those addressing group that we will study in this video? Addressing modes gets classified into 5 types. Number 1 is called as implied addressing. In this type, generally the operand is not specified and your operand is accumulated. For example, CMA. Now if you will see this instruction, CMA is your opcode, and generally after opcode we write a operand. If your instruction is without operand, then those instructions comes under the category of implied addressing mode. So implied in this type, generally operand is not specified within instruction and your operand is accumulated. See this CMA, CMA means what? Complement accumulator. So your operand is generally accumulator, which we called it as implied addressing mode. The next we have is direct addressing mode. In the direct addressing mode, the address appears after opcode of instruction in a program memory. For an example, see this instruction LDA9FFH. Now LDA9FFH means what? After your opcode, 9FFH is an address. So after opcode, directly address is given. So such type of instruction comes under category of direct addressing mode. The instruction using direct addressing mode are generally of 3 byte. For an example, see this LDA will take 1 byte, whereas this address is of 2 bytes. So altogether it will be of 3 byte instruction. Next we have is register addressing mode. In the register addressing mode, your source operands are general purpose register. For an example, when we transfer a data from one register to another register, so in that case your source operand is normally a register. So all those instructions comes under the category of register addressing mode. So they are single byte instruction. For example, just now I gave an example, move A comma B. In the move A comma B, your content of B will go to A. So here your source operand is generally what? General purpose register. Next we have is immediate addressing mode. In the immediate addressing mode, the data appears immediately after the opcode of instruction. For an example, say this ADI05. Now ADI05 means what? After your opcode, directly your data comes in the instruction. So here what you will do, you will add your 05 with the accumulator. So the data is not in any register, the data is directly specified. So such type of instructions comes under the category of immediate addressing mode. They can be either 2 byte or 3 byte of instruction. Next we have is register indirect addressing mode. In this, the content of register pair points to address of operand. The register pair HL is specified for addressing 16-bit address of memory location. So for an example, whenever memory comes, like you know, add M means what? You are adding your memory content with the accumulator, and memory points to which pair? HL pair. So register pair HL is specified for addressing 16-bit address of memory location. So all such type of instructions comes under the category of register indirect addressing mode. So how they have summarized it? The content of register pair points to address of operand. Your content of register pair, they will point to where? They will point to address of operand. So they come under the category of what? Register addressing, register indirect addressing mode. So let us have a recap of this. Number one we have is implied addressing mode. In the implied addressing mode, generally your operand is not specified and your operand is generally a accumulator. For an example, CMA, RRC, RLC, all those instruction comes under the category of what? Implied addressing mode, where the operand is not specified. Only opcode is given, then you will if only opcode is given, then from that you can easily identify okay, this instruction is under the category of what? Implied addressing mode. Then we have direct addressing mode. In the direct addressing mode, the address comes immediately after the opcode of the instruction. For an example, LDA, STA, to such kind of instruction, they come under the category of direct addressing mode. You just have to see if the address is coming immediately after the opcode, then we called it as what? Direct addressing mode. Next we saw was register addressing mode. In the register addressing mode, your source operands are generally what? Registers. I mean, they are general purpose register. So all those instructions, they come under the category of what? Register addressing mode. Immediate addressing mode. In immediate addressing mode, your data appears immediately after the instruction, then we called it as what? Immediate addressing mode. See, whenever with the instruction I comes, like, you know, MVI, ADI, SBI, then all those category of instruction, they comes under the category of immediate addressing mode, because in that data appears immediately after your opcode. And the last we have is called as register indirect addressing mode. In this, the content of register pair points to an address of operand. For an example, add M. So these are all types of addressing group. Here all instruction comes under any one of this addressing mode. So I hope you have understood the addressing modes of 8085. In the next video, we will study the data transfer group. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.